know, you've got everything from our pioneer heritage to the contemporary cowboy and our wildlife, and so, you know, it just covers the gamut there, and it's neat to see each artist's different interpretation of those different things. And
it is like an atlas of fine art, you could say.
Right, right. So that's what I enjoy about it, is you'll have artists painting very similar and sometimes the same type of subject matter, but to see their different views and interpretations of those subject matters makes it really interesting to come and view.
There's a lot of great art here, and really sort of the cream of the crop of the painters in the West and across the country. It's not just local painters that are in it. So.
Yeah, and the economy is alive and well. I think we had a million-dollar bid tonight, so that's pretty wonderful.
One of the paintings, yes, it was sold for over that. Yeah, so it wasn't mine, but that's still great for any artist to do. So.
Of course. How would you explain the American West or the paintings of the American West to the general public that haven't experienced it firsthand?
No, it's different for every painter. I paint mostly landscape work. I've gone away from figurative work in the last number of years. I've been doing this for over 40 years, and I actually moved from Los Angeles to Colorado. I grew up in Los Angeles and moved further west.
Needed the open space and set your sights.
I just wanted a little bit more sense of wilderness. But I've traveled the world painting and keep coming back to Colorado. But the American West is really, I appreciate the light and sort of a bit of the austerity and the definition of forms that are available that you don't see when they're covered up with woodland.
Honestly, the Autry does some amazing things for us, and just the fact that I can be here and represent my family is an incredible thing, and I really am inspired by my dad's artwork, and so it's just really great to be here.
Yeah, and I think to show what we've been talking tonight is the substance, the natural landscapes takes you to another place, and the artists feel that they can show their wares to the world and American heritage as well.
Right, most definitely. I mean, like, the inspiration that Tim gets for his work is incredible, and even just from the back door of our yard in Branson, Missouri, we see all of these animals, and, you know, I think that he takes that into play, and just everyone's inspired by something different, and the American West is something that we'll definitely never forget.
It seems the Western painters also express a hyper-realism, you could say, their own expression, their own truth in the paintings.
Mm-hmm. I would agree, and I think a lot of these guys are really determined to express an authenticity in their work. And we're all trying to be as honest as we possibly can, you know, with our subjects. And so I think that's a really important aspect.
So. It's true, and it draws us back always back to the heritage of the American heritage and back to where painting started. The European classicism meets Americana.
Absolutely. I think we're the historians of our, I mean, visual historians, I would say, of our time at this point in time. And actually respecting the people that we learn from and we learn from every day in the past and the present.